Hey everyone, Cursor 2.0 has just dropped, and I've got to say, it looks super interesting. I've actually switched over to using Claude Code and Codex for pretty much my day-to-day usage, but this update, I just had to check it out. And the reason why is that they've completely revamped the Cursor from the ground up. So in today's video, I'm going to take you on a whirlwind first impressions tour of all of the new features. This includes the brand new agent interface that moves away from the traditional interface that you would expect to see in an IDE. You are also now able to run multiple agents in parallel, and the best part is that you can actually use it for multiple different models as well. And then they've also got an inbuilt voice mode now. You can talk into your IDE and essentially prompt your agents to do the work. And not forgetting that they also have other cool stuff, like the browser mode, which allows you to modify your front end and select elements in your front end so that your agent is going to be able to make precise edits. And on top of that, there's just a bunch of quality of life upgrades. And the coolest thing is that they now have their own model as well. And this video is recorded fresh, coming in for the first time after not using Cursor for a long time now. So are these upgrades enough to win me back? Let's find out. Okay, so I've just reinstalled Cursor. So one of the first things you will notice with Cursor is that it actually has this agent layout versus IDE layout. And I've not actually tried this agent layout before. So you know what? I'm just going to go big or go home, right? Because I think they've been talking about how the big push now is for doing things more agentically. So let's just try and see what it is, because I'm very familiar with the file layout that is always there. Okay, so it tells me tab I for agent or composer, shift tab to plan. So that's a bit like Claude Code. And then there's this multi-agent layout. And here we are. All right. Huh, I wonder what project I should take a look at, given that it's now loaded up. Let me see how this fares with the Claudometer project that I have. So I'm going to do Cursor, and then I'm going to do this and this. All right. So this is the agent layout. And then it says Cursor 2 is here, Cursor Composer 1. It's the new agent model. So this is probably the cheetah that everybody's been talking about. There's this multi-agent interface, which is what we're looking at over here. And there's also voice input, which is really cool. So let's actually give this a shot, okay? And you can run agents in parallel, locally, or Worktrees in the cloud. So I'm going to give this a shot right now. It says, get started with agent layout, multiple agents, chat take center stage. Yeah, so the big push that they've been saying is that actually people should be going away from looking through the files and just simply be chatting with the agents. So let's see whether that is true. And then you can change the editor, unify review. All right, let's go. So let's actually try out this voice input thing. So it's Command, Shift, and Space. All right, so I'm going to start with something very simple. And it's going to allow the microphone. And, oh, so it says cat. Okay. Okay, stop. Do not do that. I've already granted access, so let's try it again. Gain familiarity with this project and create an agents.md file that will represent what this project is about. And let's submit that. And so it's going to go into this planning next moves mode. Okay. So the first thing you'll see is that if you switch to this editor view, this is your traditional like file system view. And if you do Command I, that's where Composer appears on the right. So this is the historical view that you have when you're using Cursor or you're using VS Code with all of the other kind of plugins. But this agent view is the new one where you see there's no file. And the idea here is it's all chat based, really. So let me make this a little bit bigger. And you can see it's reviewing the files now, and it's doing this things where it's creating the agents.md. So one of the main things that I noticed is that this agents.md should be capital letters, but that's not a big problem. And while this is happening, so I actually haven't used Cursor for a long time now. I've switched over to Claude Code and Codex and been predominantly using that within VS Code. So I used to use Cursor quite a lot. In fact, you could see I actually had a whole series on building games with Cursor. So it's actually a bit strange to come back to this now and see this. Okay, great. So it seems that the view actually pops up over here. And last time, this would be the composer view. So if you actually just go back to editor view, I think this is the very familiar interface that I was used to. And this agent's view is same functionality, but different paradigm, which is nice. I'm going to do keep. This is great. And then I'm going to go here and just change this to actually reflect that it should be agents.md. Okay. And then next thing here we should do is, let's try this again now. So I'm going to change this. I assume that I can actually change this, and let's use Composer 1, okay, because this is actually the one that's new. And how do I actually go ahead and spawn multiple? Do I do plan mode? Is it plan mode? So let's just try plan mode. Let's redesign this app to look visually more stunning. Okay, and is there a way that I can actually switch So this is plan mode, and let's just give this one a shot. I'm not sure exactly how you... Okay, so agent and edit. Okay, so I actually don't have a cursor console. I'm going to reactivate my cursor subscription live here. So I definitely did this quite a while ago. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually manage my subscription. Stop using it in July when I actually ended up doing more in Claude Code. But let's do this $20 a month plan and see if that's going to enable me to. Okay, I'm just going to have to get this. Okay, on my link verifications, we're at like week 193. Okay, so let's try again. This should work now. Nope. I guess I might have to do a reload window just so that it picks it up, because it's probably going to need to take some time to activate, to recognize that I have it. And let's see if this works now. So I don't know. Okay, so I'm back here. It says review button. Let's say redesign this app to make it look more visually stunning. And you can see, okay, so I think it's accepted my billing now, so it should be going ahead of it. So you can see it's got this plan mode here. So this is the new plan mode that it has. And you can see it actually creates something where it actually writes it out into a markdown file. And then you can choose to build it. And then it's built in background and built locally. Okay, so this is like me being extremely new to how this works. So I'm actually interested to know how it can spin off multiple agents. So let's see, because I'm pretty sure this is on this frontier coding model, easy to run the same models across. Let's see what it does. Great. And run it. Okay, so you've got this thing here. It seems like they were able to just change this and with multiple models, which I wasn't able to see in my view. So let's just see. Maybe I actually have to reload cursor or something. So I'm not sure how this works. Okay, you can do max. I do max mode. So yeah, I'm not sure exactly. So I'm going to figure this out. How to actually do multiple agents. So let's just try this new agent. Oh, there you go. So it's here now. So that's probably something that too. Okay, so I did do a new agent, and maybe because I wasn't on a pro plan before this, so it didn't work. So I'm just going to try this now. I'm going to use Composer 1. I'm going to compare this, right? Let's do a comparison between, let's say, Composer 1 and, I don't know, let's try GPT Sonnet 4.5. Yeah, let's do it this way. So you can actually compare across different models for the same thing. All right, so let's redesign this application such that it looks beautiful, modern, sleek, and overall aesthetically pleasing. Great. So that's going there. Okay, so you can see now it's actually going ahead and it's going to be run across Composer, GPT-5 Codex, and GPT-5 Codex says that it's... Okay, so it says that I need to... So that's interesting. It says that it's actually done. So it says I need to set up the work tree, I think. That's the reason why. So I got to do this, configure a work tree. So I'm going to save this and... Okay, so I think that didn't go the way I expected it to go. So what do I do here? We can see that this is working and it's actually finished now. Okay, probably need to set something up here for it to work, but let's actually just see and what this review does. So yeah, the thing about this is that they're saying that nobody really looks at these things when you're like you relying on agents. I guess the best way to do it is to just jump out here, view app, npm run dev, and let's just see how the app actually looks. And here it looks pretty much the same. Nope, this is looking correct. So I'm going to do reapply. I'm going to do full override. And then, yeah, it looks the same to me. So I'm not sure what is it saying. Yeah, I would say theme this completely. It looks the same. And okay, so it's updating the charts now. So I'm just wondering... It still looks the same. Do notice this transition effect, but it's overall looking pretty much the same. So I'm just going to close this and... Okay, so that's that. Retheme, it looks unclear. Okay, so let's just do reapply. Okay, so I think I've managed to crack how to actually use these multiple agents correctly. So if you actually see here, you can switch between the different models that Cursor has now. And if you actually look up here, you can see that it has different work trees. If you're not sure about what work trees are, effectively, it's almost like being able to have different branches of the same code base so that they don't conflict on each other. And that's how Cursor actually allows parallel execution of different agents. And the way that you do it is that For example, if you go over here, sometimes what you need to do is that, if you actually saw it earlier, both of them actually, while Composer actually proceeded with the implementation, these two kind of were waiting for me to say go ahead. So what I did after that was that I went to GPT-5 Codex and then I just said, go ahead then. All right. And then in 4.5, all I need to do now is say, please proceed until completion. All right. And this will allow things to actually run. I need to figure out how to do a dangerously skip permissions thing so that it doesn't keep prompting me for it. So it says that the task is completed, but I noticed that over here, it actually hasn't made any modifications to the file. So before I actually jump into this, I wanted to just show you where Composer and GPT-5 Codex got to and show you how you actually switch between the results. So if I go to Composer 1's model, I can go to review here, but I think the easiest thing to do is just to reapply and just to override. Don't try to merge anything. And then you can see that, I'm just going to bring this into screen here. It does look different. It does look less vanilla, but I'm not a big fan of the original decision of the colors and the color scheme. All right. And the way that you do, you swap back. So if I go to GPT-5 Codex's one and I do reapply and then I just do override, and you will see that this one actually is pretty nice. And this is what I've seen. If you've seen my previous videos, GPT-5 Codex tends to be a lot better at designing UI than 4.5, for example. But, and in this case, I think it does look nicer. And we're going to just see if we can actually get this to complete here. So let me see. It says run it, development service. Okay. All right. So I say, let's use the voice thing. So I'll say, please proceed with the implementation and do not stop until you're done. Keep it simple. And you added a thank you by itself. I'm not sure whether you saw that. It was just quite funny. Okay, so let's wait until 4.5 is done. You can see that it has this to-do list over here. And I think the main thing about Cursor, for those of you who are coming back from, say, using the terminal interface or using something like Claude Code or Codex CLI, I must say that it is actually really slick. Cursor has a really nice design, and having everything in one place is actually pretty cool. I think the issue I have here is that in this agent's view, I'm not sure if this actually is the kind of flow that I would be using in my kind of like day-to-day usage. When I'm in the terminal, like let Claude Code do a thing, and then I just review the files directly in VS Code. So I guess that's what it's trying to achieve here. But yeah, I guess I got used to this agent's view. Anyway, you can see that this is actually doing some migration stuff as well. And I'm not sure why it's doing that, because all I really wanted it to do was to just make the typography look a bit better. So I wonder whether I can try the revert now, because it's doing a bunch of stuff which I don't think it actually needs to do. So I'm going to just stop this. I'm going to undo all. So I'm going to revert to here, right? I'm going to say, please redesign this application such that it looks beautiful, modern, and sleek, and overall aesthetically pleasing. I'm just going to say, do not modify underlying data structures, backend, etc. All right, so let's just see if Sonnet 4.5 is going to be able to do this better. And yeah, so far, getting used to how Cursor has done this. When I do the very similar thing with Codex, it has quite a similar interface. And I would say that Codex, to me at least initially, feels a little bit more intuitive. It's just unload your changes and then it's like sync directly to the web, which is really nice. But in this case, like it took me a little bit of, okay, click here and then click on reapply, right? And then click override. And it wasn't exactly clear which worktree was going to, but then I did it now. So if I refresh this, you can see that this is the version that Composer 1 did. And then if I go here and reapply and override, then this is the GPT-5 Codex one. Okay, and the nice thing about this is that I can just create a PR straight away. So if I do a create PR over here, it actually is connects to the correct repository, which is interesting because I do not actually remember granting Cursor access to this repository. So I'm quite interested to know how I actually figured that out. But anyway, we can see this is going to continue. And I would say Composer 1 completed very quickly. GPT-5 Codex was probably a little bit slower, but still quite fast. And ultimately has the better looking of the three right now. And I can see for Sonnet 4.5 is taking its time. It's definitely a little bit slower from what I've seen, but we'll just let this run and then we'll see how it looks like. But anyway, just jumping back to this, you would have this pull request over here, and then you can actually deploy this onto a preview deployment if you wish. Okay, so this is still going, and so I'm gonna let this run until the end, and then we can take stock and see how it looks like. Okay, so it's done now, and it actually had gone through all of the 6 to-dos that it had. You can see that it's done a bunch of changes to the components. You know what? I'm just going to do apply all, overwrite, and let's just a quick look at how it looks like now. I'm just going to refresh. And so this is the Sonnet 4.5 version, and it's actually pretty cool. It still has this purple hue, which is a little bit strange, but it's quite popular whenever you're using AI models. But overall, this I really like this top keywords, multicolored packs. And sometimes a lot of people ask me and say, why would you want to have multiple runs? First of all, multiple runs, even with the same model, can give you drastically different results. If you actually see one of the videos that I did using the Codex Web and Codex IDE, you would have seen I used the same model, GPT-5, and it actually gave me 3 very different results. But this time, with Cursor, you're actually going to be able to choose between multiple different models. And I think this is just a really powerful workflow. It just gives you a lot of flexibility here. Okay, so now that we have this, I wanted to see if I can pull up the one last feature that I've read so much about is actually the browser. And all right, so you can have this browser tool over here. And I'm just going to do, is it browser tab? No, I'm going to do browser Google Chrome. So is it going to be able to connect to Chrome here? Let's just try this. So browser tab. And I'm going to type in localhost 3000. And as you can see, this is one of the cool features of Cursor, is that you can actually have this live preview here. And the best thing about this is that you can actually select elements. So we can select elements here within this. And I can say something like this element that I over here. And I've selected it. And then you can see it's popped down into this chat over here. And this time I'm going to create something new. So let me just try this again. So I'm going to do select element, and then I'm just going to select everything here. And you can see it selected this div, and I said, don't like the color scheme views here, please fix it. And this time I'm just going to swap back to Composer 1 because it's really quick and I don't need multiple runs this time. So I'm going to say something, a pulse in all classes. So you can actually select elements within the browser. And it's just very powerful because you no longer have to take screenshots of the elements. You get the exact elements themselves. And I think this is actually really powerful as a way to debug your applications and your front end. Okay. So you see this is done, it's not. And then let's actually just open the browser again and let's see what happened here. Okay, so yeah, you can see that it's actually changed this now, so it doesn't have that strange purple hue and everything else is the same. So yeah, so this is the other feature that Cursor has now. And I think overall, just first impressions, I haven't used Cursor for several months now. And so that's the reason why I'm like a little bit rusty about where things are. But first impressions is that very interesting. Definitely has taken inspiration from a lot of other things like Codex IDE with this multiple agent runs. Yes, definitely has a very slick interface. Still not quite sure about what to think about this agent's view compared to just using typical editor and composer on the side view. Having the browser inside with the selection is really cool. And overall, I think it's worth a deeper dive very soon to figure out how to get the best out of it. I really hope you enjoyed this very raw first look at Cursor. And if you like this video, don't forget to give it a like, hit that subscribe button, and turn on notifications so that you're always the first to know whenever new content like this drops. And I actually just did an entire video on Claude Code and its latest features called Skills. And so if you want to check that out and learn how this new feature really changes how you use something like Claude Code, you want to check out this video over here. So if there's anything else you love for me to deep dive into more with the new Cursor 2.0 release, let me know in the comments. Until next time, see ya.